Hi, my name is Parker, and today I'm going to set up the ScreenBeam Classroom Commander wireless orchestration system, and you're going to see just how easy it is to use. The first thing you'll need to do is plug in all the necessary cables. Classroom Commander comes with an HDMI cable and a power supply. You'll need a USB cable for touch-enabled displays. Now turn the display on, ensuring the input is set to the corresponding HDMI port. Soon, the Ready to Connect screen will appear on the display, telling you that the ScreenBeam receiver is ready for the teacher and students to connect. In order to connect, the ScreenBeam Classroom Commander teacher and student apps must first be installed on the desired devices. For Windows MSI installer packages, visit this website and simply click on the ScreenBeam Classroom Commander app. Or, for the UWP app, open the Microsoft Store on any Windows 10 device and search for Classroom Commander for the teacher and student applications. Then, launch the Classroom Commander teacher and student apps on their respective devices. You will first be prompted with a login dialog to connect. Select Connect, then select the appropriate receiver from the Connect menu. You will then be prompted to enter a PIN number. The default PIN is 123-456-70. Your IT department has the option to change the PIN, so if you have any questions, be sure to ask them. If the receiver is connected to an interactive touch display or projector, you must select the checkbox for Allow Mouse, Keyboard, Touch, and Pen Input from this device for touch and touchback to work. By using Miracast to create peer-to-peer wireless connections, the ScreenBeam Classroom Commander creates an in-room hub for wireless connectivity, enabling wireless, screen sharing, and classroom orchestration without using up bandwidth or impacting your infrastructure network. Now that all the devices are connected, the student devices show up as thumbnails on the homeroom screen of the teacher device. If you want a closer look at any of the student devices, just double-click on the desired thumbnail to enter monitor mode. Here, with real-time monitoring, you can cycle through the student screens, both automatically and manually, as well as take screenshots by clicking the camera icon. To go back to the homeroom, just click on the home icon. To project the teacher's screen to the display connected to the receiver, simply click the beam icon in the menu tab. Clicking this icon again will close the projection. Likewise, to project a student's display, select their thumbnail and press the beam student screen icon. Click on the icon again to close the projection. When projecting the teacher or student screens, if the connected display is touchscreen equipped, the presenter can utilize the wireless inking and touchback features. Also, the teacher can lock device functionality for a single student, several students, or even the entire classroom. Select the desired thumbnails and click on the silence/unsilence icon to block their screens. Clicking on the icon again will undo this action. To access the remote commands, click on the drop-down arrow next to the Send Remote Command to Students button. This will open a drop-down menu providing four actions. Open Website allows you to launch a web page directly to the student's devices, so the teacher can lead the class in a guided web lesson or other activity, while Start Program will open an application that the teacher chooses on the student devices. Disconnect will remove students from the Classroom Commander network, and Shutdown will turn off their devices. And for increased efficiency in communication, the chat feature allows for private or group messages between the teacher and students. The teacher can initiate conversations by selecting the appropriate thumbnails and clicking the Start Chat with Selected Students icon. In the chat window that appears, type in your message and click Send. For a student to initiate a conversation with the teacher's status must first be set to Available or Away in the status box. Then the student will click on the Chat button in the Communicate box to display the chat window. Now you have all the instruments at your disposal for wireless classroom orchestration.